Hi everyone. Today, I'm at the Fred Hutchinson Cancer Center, where I'm going to be having a conversation with the professor of radiology, Savannah Partridge. Her work is at the forefront of breast cancer research using magnetic resonance imaging. And today, we're going to be exploring a really fascinating question. How can we use AI to help radiologists better detect breast cancer and diagnose it even faster using MRIs?
You can't find answers without asking the right questions. This is The Prompt with me, Trevor Noah.
Dr. Partridge, thank you for your time.
Wow, it's great to meet you.
It seems like the field of medicine is one where you always need a human. I mean, you're scanning through images, you're trying to detect breast cancer. What is the problem that needs to be solved in breast cancer and prevention?
We know that earlier detection can save lives, and we do this through screening. But our screening tools are still imperfect, and so there's ways that we want to make them better so we can detect cancer earlier. We know that mammograms have some limitations. Women with dense breasts are at higher odds of having a cancer missed on their mammogram because it's actually hidden by that dense fibroglandular tissue on the image. That constitutes about half of the women in the United States, so this is a big problem.
I mean, we have MRIs, we have mammograms, so what's the problem?
Right, so MRIs are not impacted by breast density, so we know we can use them for screening women with dense breasts, but the problem is that because they're so sensitive, they also have a high rate of false positives. So this means that while it's very good at detecting cancer, it can also detect benign findings that look like cancer. This can lead to need for additional imaging exams and even unnecessary biopsies. And so that's something that obviously adds to the anxiety and stress for patients.
So when there's a false positive, is this because of the image itself or is it because of the interpretation on the doctor's side?
Some benign findings really do look like cancers from the way that we're able to recognize them. What we're looking for is an area where we inject a contrast agent and the contrast leaks out in areas of suspicious tissue. And you can see right here this little bright area. This is pretty subtle, but it is something that was picked up on by the radiologist at the time reading this breast MRI, and subsequently it was determined to be benign. So this was a false positive.
How is AI understanding what maybe we can't when we're the ones teaching it? Have we figured out what AI is seeing in the images that creates a different understanding of what a positive is or isn't?
That's a great question. The power of AI is being able to aggregate images from thousands of women that we already have in hand where we know the outcomes and apply AI to learn the very subtle features that are indicative of cancer and then apply that when we introduce a new exam.
By having the ability to correlate all these different ideas and findings and everything, is there a question you're trying to answer that you hope AI could help with?
There's compelling evidence that the information that's contained in these images are actually giving us some information about how likely a woman is for developing cancer in the next few years.
Oh, wow.
So even healthy women that are getting their annual screening, we could possibly even think about preventing some women from developing cancer in the first place by guiding them towards prevention strategies if they're identified to be at high risk.
It's really fascinating, and it's exciting to see what you're doing. Another example of AI for good. Thank you so much for your time, Dr. Partridge.
Thank you.